My name is Joseph Edgehill, and I'm an immigrant from Trinidad and Tobago. I'm now a naturalized U.S. citizen over 20 years. I came to this country in 1974. I've always been proud to have come to the U.S. to be an American, and I guess over time I never really wanted to be political, but I just kind of settled into becoming a Republican, and I can't honestly tell you why. I felt like maybe that was how Christians voted. I felt it was a little bit more on the anti-abortion side. So that's basically how I voted, but I tried to stay out of politics for most of my life. However, over time, as different presidents came and went, finally Donald Trump showed up in 2016, and I was attracted to him as a candidate just because he was different. He just was so non-political. He just did not sound like a politician at all. So I voted for him. I thought, let's give him a chance. And I saw some red flags before he was elected. And even after he was elected at the beginning, I thought he was interesting. In fact, I found it kind of amusing that he would do and say things that would get the left all stirred up. But then over time, I began to realize he wasn't playing games. This was exactly who he was. And he was as outrageous or even more than he seemed to me by his behavior and his words. So over time, it just took a little time. But right around May of this year is when it finally hit me and I realized I can't support this anymore. COVID was what turned me around. And so did George Floyd and how he handled that whole situation. But, you know, but honestly, there's one group of people I really want to focus on, and that's Christians who support Trump, Christian Republicans who support Trump, or Christians at all who support Trump. And I guess I'm just absolutely amazed that people who are supposedly good moral people, God-fearing people, cannot see through the horrible, despicable character of this man and continue to support, defend the most ludicrous things that he says. That's the group of people that puzzle me. And honestly, I'm almost to the point where I can say I don't even want to be a Christian anymore. If this is what being a Christian is, how can you support this? So if there's any way what I'm saying might influence a Christian to think twice about what they're seeing, to use the discernment of God and the Holy Spirit inside of them to look at this man and say, is this really who Jesus would vote for? I hope it makes some small difference. But I am no longer going to vote for him, for sure. And I think I'm pretty sure I'm going to go ahead and vote Democratic. And I am also going to vote across the board for Democratic candidates because I am just as upset that the Republican Party would support and put this man up as their candidate. But again, to summarize, COVID and George Floyd are what did it for me. And I am moving forward with that. And I really don't care who comes along with me or not. And I hope what I'm sharing might make a small difference to get some and other people to turn against him. Thank you for listening, and God bless you all.